What's up?
D-Xylose test is a method that we use to assess the absorptive capacity of the duodenum. The most common condition where we use D-Xylose test are celiac disease or lactose intolerance. So, to explain the logic of this test, let's take as an example lactose intolerance.
Is that goat cheese?
Chèvre. Yes, that is a goat cheese.
Because I have a lactose reflux and I can't.
You're lactose intolerant?
Yeah, but I can't.
Or you have acid reflux. They're different things.
I know what they are.
So you misspoke.
Well, thank you for correcting me.
There is a part of the duodenum, we have enterocytes that have glute transporters, and also we have a blood compartment. So let's suppose that we intake some portion of lactose. Lactose is disaccharide that consists of glucose and galactose. The problem with all disaccharides is that we cannot absorb them, because enterocytes do not have transporter for them. Enterocytes have only glute transporter that can transport only monosaccharides. So because lactose is disaccharide, initially it must be degraded to monosaccharides. This degradation is provided by the specific enzyme called lactase, which is located on the brush border of enterocytes. Lactase degrades lactose to glucose and galactose. Then both of them are absorbed by enterocytes through a glute transporter into the blood. In the blood, galactose is converted into glucose, and together this causes elevation of blood glucose level. But in some cases, this process can be disrupted.
With all due respect, what the fuck are you talking about?
For example, if we do not have lactase enzyme, we cannot provide degradation of disaccharides into monosaccharides. And because we cannot absorb disaccharides, in this case absorption will be impossible, so there will be no elevation in blood glucose level. Instead, lactose simply will be excreted in the feces. Another possibility is damage to enterocytes in the duodenum. For example, in celiac disease, lactase is present, so patient will degrade disaccharides into monosaccharides. But the problem is that damaged enterocytes do not have glute transporters, so they cannot absorb glucose and galactose from the intestine into the blood. And in this case, both glucose and galactose will be excreted in the feces. So how to tell where is the problem? Because we have to decide, is the problem with enzymes, or it's a problem with absorption due to the damage to enterocytes. So to solve this problem, we give to patient a simple monosaccharide as D-Xylose.
Well, what did he do that for?
Don't know, sir.
In this case, because it's monosaccharide, we do not need enzymes. We need just glute transporter on enterocytes. Glute transporter transports D-Xylose into the bloodstream. Then D-Xylose is converted into glucose, and as a result blood glucose level increase. So if everything works fine, the intake of D-Xylose causes increase in blood glucose level. But if damage to duodenum occurs, glute transporters on enterocytes becomes disrupted. So now even absorption of monosaccharides as D-Xylose becomes impossible. As a result, there will be no increase in blood glucose level.
Wait a minute.
So if enterocytes work fine, intake of D-Xylose causes increase in blood glucose level. Then probably the causative factor is absence of enzyme because absorption works fine.
Great.
But if intake of D-Xylose do not cause increase in blood glucose level, then we can say that the causative factor is damage to duodenum that causes a malabsorption of carbohydrates.
What did we learn, Palmer?
I don't know, sir.
I don't fucking know either.
Okay. Fine. Yep. Ciao!
What's that mean?
Ciao. It's Italian. It means food.